Good morning and thank you for joining us today. Our presider is our parochial vicar, Father Bill. Please rise as we begin this celebration.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
Good morning. I didn't hear myself being called for Mass. I was sitting out there hearing music being played, and somebody said, are you going to go in and celebrate Mass? Well, it's that Pavlonian thing that I've been raised with the dinner bell. If they don't ring the bell, I don't come. So, as we enter into the celebration today, we celebrate the feast of St. Maximian Kolbe, a wonderful priest, Franciscan, and martyr of the church. And so as we celebrate his life, we always begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace and love of God our Father and of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with you.
Today, as we enter into God's presence, he calls us to recognize his mercy and his grace for us. Lord, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
you have come to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who filled the priest and martyr, St. Maximian Kolbe, with the burning love for the Immaculate Virgin Mary, with zeal in the soul and the love of neighbor, graciously grant that through his intercession, that striving for your glory by eagerly serving others, we may be conformed even until death to your Son, who lives and reigns with you and you to the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the fool, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in a furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I believed even when I said, I am greatly afflicted. I said in my alarm, no man is dependable. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. O Lord, I am your servant. You have loosed my bonds. To you I will offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia. Let your heart rejoice in the Lord. Let your word proclaim his deeds. Let your voice sing out to the world that our God has come to save. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. I was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appoint you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you." The Gospel of the Lord. I think sometimes in our relationship of life, we sometimes forget that God has chosen us. I remember as a young man, before Vatican II, the church had this idea that, you know, God was way out there and we are way down here. And the veil of heaven is kind of that thing that we can't get past because the old term that they used to use for us, where they called us a bunch of pagan children. because we weren't necessarily worthy of God's redemption. We had to make ourselves worthy. But then later on, learning about this worthiness because Christ has made us worthy. This new language of Vatican II and John the 23rd talking about renewing the face of the earth and calling forth a new understanding, a new kind of a reconciliation of the church back to going even as far back as the early church. I was blessed to go to the beatification and the canonization of Maximilian Kolbe. My chaplain in the army, which I was still in Germany at the time, had set up a trip for a bunch of us to go to his beatification, and then the following year to his canonization. And I remember going there, and I remember meeting the man that Maximilian died for, the one he gave up his life for. And he was wearing his prison outfit, his internment outfit, to the celebrations, both of them, reminding himself of the selflessness and the love that Maximilian showed him. And it's a powerful story because this guy is, what has happened is in the camp, there were some escapes, and so the Germans lined up at random a bunch of people to be put into a place to be basically starved to death as a reminder of the retribution that will occur if people try to escape. And so this gentleman, a Jewish man, with children still alive, asking, please, please, not me. I have a family, I want to live. Maximilian, Franciscan, a priest, a man of heart that served the people in the camp, even up until this time, saying, I'm willing to go. I'm willing to give my life for this man. And the double kind of entendre of the situation is that the Germans lost in both causes, because they lost because the men died because of the courage Maximilian gave them each as they were all going to their end. He gave them courage to recognize that God was going to greet them and take them to himself. They would not die in vain, but they were dying for the faithfulness of their relationship to God. And even Maximilian himself, when the guard came to inject him with the serum to kill him because he wasn't dying, as they thought he would, that they injects us, when before he injects the serum, Maximilian says the words of Jesus, I forgive you for what you're about to do. I forgive you for what you're about to do. And looks at them, he looks at this sergeant with the eyes of love, the eyes of Christ. And how the story goes that it shook the hope that the Germans had of bringing about fear and discouragement, but rather courage. Courage. I believe I remember the Holy Father talking about that at both the beatification and the canonization of his life, is that the courage that the Lord gave to Maximilian, to going to the camp, to being a witness of Christ in the camp, being a witness of Christ with his death, seeing his death as his own crucifixion, that he would die for the love of God's people. And so, it just was a really kind of a mystifying experience to be before. And I still remember him every time this day comes. I remember him as though I knew him. And I knew him because of my relationship of that experience, my relationship of meeting the man he died for, my relationship of being a member of the community of life, of calling forth the canonization and the beatification in the square of St. Peter's. And that's what we're called to do, is recognize the one who calls us recognizing his words to us. It is not you who chose me, but I who chose you. Chose us from the beginning of time when the Father gave him the command to go forth and to create. And that creating love continues to be as it continues to choose us. To choose us because he has loved us. And his proof of love is in his saints. Especially a person like Max Mayne Colby. A proof of the witness of God's love still alive in our midst is because of these saints who show that love of God as we are given and asked to have the same courage to be the witnesses of love in our world. Let us turn to the Lord with our prayers as we call upon his name. We pray through the intercession of St. Maximilian Kolbe, both saint and martyr of the church, that his intercessions for us may help us to draw our hearts more closely to the love of Christ. We pray to the Lord. We pray to the intercessions of Our Lady, whom Maximilian was greatly fond of, creating his village of the Immaculate Heart of Mary before the time of the persecution of the Germans in his life, that we may recognize how Mary is a component who leads us to the love of her Son. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who are in need of our prayers. Special intention that I promise to pray for, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Bob Cantwell, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who are waiting the Lord in their time, as well as those who feel hopelessness or helplessness because of this pandemic, and the inability for us to reach out to them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for this community, that we may always recognize the ways that the Lord calls us to a transfigurative love. In his name, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers that are in silence of each one of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of mercy, you gave us the gift of Maximilian Kolbe to be a witness of Christ in our world and in our time. Help us to always be courageous in what we do and in how we live, witnessing your grace and your mercy in this world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
We present our oblation to you, O Lord, humbly praying that we may learn from the example of Saint Maximilian to offer our very lives for you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God. For you are glorified in your Saint Maximilian Kolbe, who praised the very suffering by the wonders of your might. And in the mercy, you gave him great faith. To endure, you gave him firm resolution. And to struggle in victory, you gave him the gift of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song of adoration, as with the hosts of angels we cry out without end as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, gave you thanks. He broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, we we celebrate the memorial of the death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Holy Father, with Gregory John, the Archbishop, with Joel and Bernard, his brother bishops, and all your clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome into life your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and her blessed spouse, St. Joseph, with the blessed apostles, with St. Maximian Kolbe, and with all your saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Alleluia. Amen.
Our Savior has taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. By the help of your mercy, make us always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, My peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Bread of life, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace, grant us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. If you're joining us online, please pray this prayer at this time. My Jesus, on the day of my baptism, you poured your love into my heart through the Holy Spirit, who unites me eternally to you. Through that same Spirit, I pledge my love and adore you, present in your most holy body and blood. Though I cannot consume you in this sacred banquet, let me be consumed by your complete desire for me, so that my longing for you may be filled by your love alone, and your mercy overflow through me into this world so in need. Amen.
There is
is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Live on in my love. You will live in my love if you keep my commands, even as I have kept my Father's. There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend. All this I tell you that my joy may be yours, and your joy may be complete. Love one another as I have loved you. This is my command. There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend. You are my friends if you keep my commands, no longer slaves but friends to me. All I heard from my Father I have made known to you. Now I call you friends. There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend. It was not you who chose me, it was I who chose you to go forth and bear fruit. Your fruit must endure, so you will receive all you ask the Father in my name. There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that renewed in body and blood of your Son, we may be inflamed with the same fire of charity that St. Maximin Kolbe received in his holy banquet through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Mighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We go forth this day to love, serve, and to grow in the awareness of God's love for us. Thank you all for this day.